Amongst the urines, the most beneficial is the urine of the Bedouin camels. The urine of the camel can be used in treatments of certain skin diseases like tinea, like ringworm, like sores, like abscesses, dry and wet ulcers. And scientific research has proven that camel's urine, it makes the hair lustrous and thick, and is also used in the prevention of dandruff. Camel's urine can be used as treatment for certain skin diseases like eczema, can be used for allergies, for sores, for burns, for acne, for nail infection. It can also be used as a treatment for hepatitis. The camel's urine can be used in treatment of cancer. This urine has got anti-cancer properties and can be used in the treatment of cancer. As a Muslim, we believe in it. Amanna Sadakna. If it's the verse of the Quran, we check it. It's part of the Quran. We believe in it. If it's a hadith, we verify whether it's authentic hadith, whether it's a sahih hadith, and we believe in it. Then later on, we can do research whether science has agreed with it or not. But science is not the criteria. But science is not the criteria.
But science is not the criteria
to identify whether we have to believe in the hadith or not. To identify the hadith has to be believed or not, we have to check its authenticity, and that was discussed by me, Tahir, it is pure. According to the fuqahas, according to Islamic scholars, they say that any animal which is permitted for a Muslim to eat, or any bird which is permitted for a Muslim to eat, that animal or that bird's urine and feces is tahir, it is pure, it is not najis. For example, if a pigeon lays a dropping and it falls onto your shoulder, on your clothes, then that part doesn't become najis, it is tahir. You can take it off, you can brush it off, if it dries, you can wash it, no problem, but it is not najis. Similarly, the urine and feces of all the animals which we are permitted to eat, whether it be goat, whether it be sheep, whether it be camel, whether it be cow, it is not najis. So based on this, according to the fuqahas, according to Islamic scholars, the urine of the cow is not najis.
Yunus ne bayan kiya unse ibn Shahab Zahri ne ke maine Abu Idris se pucha, kya hum dawa ke taur par گدھی کے دودھ سے وضو کر سکتے ہیں یا اسے پی سکتے ہیں یا درندہ جانوروں کے پتے استعمال کر سکتے ہیں یا اونٹ کا پیشاب پی سکتے ہیں ابو ادریس نے کہا کہ مسلمان اونٹ کے پیشاب کو دوا کے طور پر استعمال کرتے تھے ابو ادریس نے کہا کہ مسلمان اونٹ کے پیشاب کو دوا کے طور پر استعمال کرتے تھے اور اس میں کوئی حرج نہیں سمجھتے تھے
الحمد لله الحمد لله الحمد لله الحمد لله